She was also married. She lived in San Antonio. And things were going good with her marriage. But then, I guess, financial problems and problems with their past ultimately ended up ending their relationship. She actually was the one who ended the relationship with her husband, and soon after she ended up being involved with another man, but he ended up serving the military and was stationed in Germany, and due to, you know, the long distance nature of the relationship, it just, you know, it didn't work out, so she didn't have the best of luck with relationships. But again, she was young, you know, so she had plans to move back where her parents lived or where she was brought up. So that was her plan. I did read, and I didn't write it down in my notes, I don't think I did, but she did have a roommate, I believe by the name of Tori, something like that. So she was living with someone at the time of her disappearance. So the day of her disappearance, she decided to go visit her mom. Her mom actually explains that she was pretty shocked to see her daughter. There was no heads up that she was going to visit her mom. No conversation about it. And it was 8 p.m. when she decided to visit her mom. She stated that she wanted to just, you know, catch up with her mom. And, you know, everything was hunky-dory. She also proceeded to go to her sister's room and conversate with her. But then, within that time frame, she decided she wanted to go clubbing, which to me personally is a total 360, because she had stated she wanted to catch up with her mom. So she, you know, got all dolled up, dressed up. She put on some, like, gaucho pants. They were, like, a rusty color. Like, I'm guessing, like, a terracotta kind of color gaucho pants that were in at the time. They kind of, like, flare out. Heels and, yeah. She was ready to go, but before she proceeded out the door, she did ask her parents if they had extra cash on them, because she didn't have a lot of gas in her car. But the problem was, her mom and dad did not have a lot of money, and you know, it wasn't yet payday. For me, if I know I don't have a lot of gas in my car and I don't have money, I'm not gonna go clubbing. I'm not gonna run the risk of staying somewhere stranded, you know? Especially being a woman, and if she was driving by herself, even more so. Or she could have called one of her friends that she was going to meet up with. That's another thing. She told her mom that she decided to go clubbing with some of her friends. Her mom to this day has no clue who those friends are, and her mom didn't really have a close relationship with any of her friends, so she doesn't really know which friends she would have met up with. She is guessing that it, you know, may have been some old high school friends that she was catching up with, but that is just a guess. We still don't know to this day. So there's that, which is pretty interesting. But yeah, so she ended up leaving without any gas money, knowing that she didn't have a lot of gas in her tank. And she headed out to go to the club. So say it's not true. I can't say for sure, but when I was doing my research, a lot of places did state that she first headed to the pawn shop. But I'm, you know, if she did go to the pawn shop, I would think that she would get, you know, she would have had money to fill up her tank. So, yeah, I don't know. I don't quite believe that one, but let's just say she might have gone to the pawn shop. But to go to the pawn shop for gas, that's kind of extreme. But so she then went to the Graham Central Station, which is a nightclub. She arrived there at 10:30 p.m. And what's really strange is that she did not know the location. She had actually called the nightclub several of times to try to get directions. So it seems as though she was lost, didn't really know where she was going. I believe it was like an hour away from her parents. So a pretty decent distance. So, again, I don't see if she was going to meet up with her friends, why they didn't just all go together, but especially if she didn't really know the place. So by the time she arrives at the nightclub, she basically was like all out of gas. So she was seen by the surveillance camera, and she was talking to different people around her. We assume she was asking for help, possibly asking for gas money. We do not know if she did in fact get help. That still remains a mystery. It's unclear if she got any assistance. Brandy's car was found 5 days later after her disappearance. She had a black four-door Grand Prix, I think it was. Yeah, a Pontiac Grand Prix. I don't know my cars, guys. And it was parked westbound on Interstate 20 at Texas Highway 31, just outside of Longview. Now, her belongings were inside of her car, which is a red flag in itself. Her wallet, her purse, and her ex-boyfriend's cell phone were all in the car. So, no signs of Wells at the scene, no signs of struggle. And the weird thing is that the seat was pushed all the way back. Now, Brandy was 4'11", I'm 5 feet. So she was really, really short. Well, I'm 5'1". But yeah, she was 4'11". And the seat was pushed all the way back, indicating, well, just, we can only assume, but that someone much taller than Brandy was driving the car. That's just an assumption. Our mother does believe that someone else was occupying the car. The person who did whatever to Brandy. That is why the seat was found that way. Another thing that's really strange was that there was a plastic gas can. And Brandy's entire family states that that was not Brandy's whatsoever. So they do believe that that belongs to the person in which most likely did something to Brandy. plastic gas can. I think that, you know, maybe it started intention of helping her and then led to something else. Or maybe the intention was bad from the get-go. But I think something definitely happened in regards to the whole gas situation. I think someone, like I said, offered to help probably stopped at a gas station, got the plastic gas can, proceeded to put gas in the car, and then while they were both in the car, something happened. I don't know, but again, there was no struggle that they could tell anyways. Some say that her car got stranded due to not having gas, and she just like wandered off somewhere, but that doesn't ring true in my mind. And another thing, and I couldn't find it anywhere whether the car had gas or did not have gas, because that would definitely help the situation. So I don't know. If the car had gas, then someone put gas in the car. If the car did not have gas, then yeah, so I don't know if the gas can that they found was still full with the gas. It didn't really clarify. But I think that's exactly what happened, and maybe the man who called is the man who did something and decided to make up some story out of guilt and to try to somehow put Brandy's mom at ease, which does not help. But there's also just twisted people that like to, you know, mess with people's heads. So, that is the disappearance of Brandy Wells. The case is still open, and, you know, there's not a lot of solid evidence, besides the surveillance cam. And just, you know, the way the car was found and just having her personal belongings in her car. That is it for this case. I hope that there's a conclusion. I hope all cases find a conclusion, which I know is not something that, you know, will happen, but it's just really, really sad. I also chose this case because I remember reading about this case. I graduated in 2005, and you know, she disappeared in 2006, and you know, I'm kind of that like overly cautious kind of person when it comes to like leaving the house by myself. I rarely leave the house by myself, so it just breaks my heart that, you know, she did end up, you know, going to the club on her own. And again, like, we don't know which friends she met up with. Some say that she was like into drugs, and that's why she needed the money, and that's why she went to the club, and that's also why, you know, we have never heard of any friends, because she wasn't meeting any friends. She just was looking for a quick fix. But, you know, people say a lot.